My name is Crystal Romero, and this is my last lecture. When I think of family, I think of everyone, including my grandparents, uncles, aunts, and cousins. To this day, I still don't know the names of most of them. I really admire my parents. They support my family and do anything for us without ever asking why. My dad is a comedian in the sense that we laugh at him rather than with him. I have two older siblings, and out of the three of us, my dad tends to coddle me the most. Most kids I know went to preschool, but for me, there was no need to because I had my dad. Thanks to him, I didn't have to go through an extra year of school, so I guess it was worth it. My mom is a wholehearted person, and she does everything to provide for me and my siblings. I remember in kindergarten, when we had a field trip to the Aquarium of the Pacific, I asked if I could have some ice cream. She ended up buying the entire group some too. My mom is cool. As I mentioned before, I'm the youngest of three siblings. My older brother Gabe, who I call Kuya, is the oldest. My sister Janelle, who I call Ate, is the middle child. My brother and I have more of the same personality. We are both very weird and have a common sense of humor. We have the same aspect of independence and control of what we do and how we do them. And with my sister, I always wanted to copy her and do everything with her, but we managed to find a way to create a catfight out of everything. But what two sisters aren't like that? My parents attempted to enroll me in every social activity they could think of, but quitting was a recurring concept that my parents couldn't fix. At first I tried swim, but then I quit. And then there was ballet, and then I quit. Then I decided to join tennis, and I thought I was pretty good, but the coaches didn't think so. It wasn't until I tried out for volleyball that I actually enjoyed a sport. I ended up being pretty decent at it, so I stayed on the team for 4 years. Basketball, on the other hand, was another story. It wasn't for me at all. Now that I look back on it, I never once scored a point throughout the entire season. I was so bad and scared to play that I used to ask my coach if I could stay benched when he wanted to put me in the game. I then decided to take a chance in educational events. I became a participant in my school spelling bee for about 5 years in a row, placing in the top three each time. I became a part of the decathlon team in 8th grade, and my group and I all prepared for 4 months until the big competition. Me being me, I crammed everything the night before. It paid off though, because I ended up placing 4th individually for my subject. Then during sophomore year, I decided to join ASB. Turns out I'm going to be the junior class president next year, so yeah, maybe it's best that I stick to more educational things rather than athletic stuff. My uncle is a very important person in my life. He was the one who gave me my nickname, Diva. I used to hate that nickname so much I got upset whenever they called me that, which shows a great example of my diva attitude. At school, I think people see me as someone who giggles a lot and laughs at everything when it's not even funny. At home, my family recognizes a different side of me when I'm either really weird and goofy, or I'm extremely moody and want to shut everything out. My attitude is something that I'm still working on. I know I will always have a second home at St. Irenaeus, where I attended school from kindergarten until 8th grade. As St. Irenaeus became my second home, I also gained a second family. From our graduating class of 30 students, 10 of us attended Cypress High School. We all still make time to hang out with each other, even though some of us went off to different schools. The memories that I've made with them are ones I will cherish forever, and I hope that we will continue to stay close with one another as we grow older. I am so blessed that I gained a lifetime group of friends that I consider my family. Going to Cypress High School was probably one of the most difficult transitions I have ever been through. It was overwhelming to be surrounded from 300 people to 1,000 in just one day. However, I've made so many new friends since then, and now I know that it was all worth it. I've been surrounded by people who make me happy, laugh hard, and make high school just a little bit easier. I must understand what I'm capable of doing, defy my boundaries, and keep trying things until I find what I truly enjoy. In order for me to become a stronger person, I can never forget my roots and those who are there for me even when I am not my strongest. During difficult times that I know for sure I would go through, all I need to do is take a deep breath and realize how blessed my life really is. I guess it could be called a self-discovery journey, but I'm still discovering things about myself every day.